What's up, everybody? It's Mario here, and in this video, I want to talk to you about the internal battle that makes the difference between you achieving good results with your fitness, sort of like a decent physique, the results that you're kind of settling for that are okay, versus achieving an incredible physique, versus achieving a mind-blowing result, the body transformation that blows people's minds when they see your picture. And this one I'm going to talk about here makes about half of the whole journey. The other half is the good stuff, the calories, the macros, the planning, the strategy, the exercise plan, optimizing everything in your lifestyle, building great habits, all that good stuff. That's about a half of it. The other half is what I'm going to talk about in this video, and this is often the most neglected half. And if you neglect this, if you neglect what's going on here, the internal battle, you're not likely to succeed. You're very, very likely to fail. And I've been in this field for 8 years already. I've done 10,000 hours plus coaching. I work with hundreds of clients all around the world. The internal battles are often much harder to overcome than external battles, like figuring out your meal plan, figuring out what you're gonna eat, how you're gonna deal with external circumstances. So the internal battle, what is it? How does it really manifest itself? Well, if you've ever dieted down like myself, I'm gonna use myself here as an example because a lot of you guys know that, you know, I go really lean at some point. I get down 8% body fat. If you've been following me now on social media, I'm going through a cut right now where I'm going even below 8% body fat. I'm gonna get to stage a level of leanness. And throughout this journey, I basically start out at about 16% body fat, 15-16% body fat, and I go down all the way to 7%. Now, what's happening, and there are certain stages as I go down, I notice that my internal battles become much harder than my external battles. Because I've been doing this for so long, now I can finally just not focus so much on the external because I know exactly what I need to do. I have my plan outlined, I know my body, I know how things work, I know how to plan it, I know how to structure everything. But internally, I'm now facing challenges and same challenges that you guys are facing as well. And I'm gonna give you an example here. When you go down from 15 to about 10 or 11 to 12% body fat, you know, the first thing that happens is your mind starts telling you, you know, you're good enough. Why do you wanna go leaner? Why do you wanna challenge yourself further? Why go even leaner than this? You're already lean. Like you can see a clear six pack, you're already good enough. Why push yourself any further? Why do that when you can eat more food now? Your business is gonna suffer because of that. You're gonna get moody. Your things that you like to do in your life are gonna be much harder because you will get more anxious. You're gonna be more stressed out because there's not enough food. You're gonna be in a deficit and it's gonna be more annoying for the people around you. So why do that? You know, forget about it. I know you said everybody and then you said to yourself that you're actually gonna get leaner this time, but you know, why not just stop here? Because you know, you already done a good job. And that's like the first challenge that you guys will also face. Whether you're starting at 20% or 25 or 30% body fat, it doesn't matter. Your mind is gonna start feeding you your inner voice, that this lesser version of yourself will try to self-sabotage you. And I've been listening to this voice and I'm listening to the other voice of me, which is basically the voice that is telling me, hey, look, this is a challenge. You wanna be the best version of yourself. You made a promise to yourself. You made a promise to the world. You made a promise to people around you. You made these goals and they're real and you have the vision and keep reminding yourself the vision. So I have these two voices basically that are fighting each other all the time, right? You can imagine them sort of as having this little devil here and this angel here, and they're constantly fighting each other and they're giving you certain suggestions. And in the moments of weakness, actually, the sort of the devilish personality here can come through to you, can really get to you, and you can really, you know, let loose and go all full on YOLO mode, and you know, you can lose and destroy weeks of progress. And this is what I see as a coach. I see, you know, lots of people in my program, we really work on this intensely, but outside when I see a lot of people that I don't really have a lot of interaction with, I see a lots of ups and downs. I see lots of people that, you know, they stick to a plan and they get some decent results, but then they start self-sabotaging themselves. They start getting looser. They start forgetting about their goal. They start forgetting about why they even do this. And they start settling for less. And this is the same thing in business that I see. See the exact same thing. In business, a lot of guys, you know, they start making some income online, and I've been fortunate enough to meet a lot of people across like the last 10 years that I've been in this, and first starting off as a freelancer, sort of like the nomad. Then I switched to being an entrepreneur running my own business, my coaching company. And I've seen a lot of guys, you know, who just start making, you know, like $1,000, $2,000, you know, they move to like Asia somewhere, and that's basically their ceiling. They don't want to keep working on it anymore. And I'm not saying that this is bad or anything like that. If you really are happy, and I'm not saying that you should be continuously, you know, chasing money as one of the big things in your life. I definitely don't do that. It's not like one of the biggest, the most important things in my life, not by far. But I just see a lot of people, again, they're really eager to settle when if they put in just a little bit more effort, they would see like exponentially better results. And the same thing happens in fitness. Like if you put in a little bit more effort, you could just go from good to great, and you could really see what the best version of yourself looks like. And oftentimes what I hear stories and what I used to tell myself kind of is, you know, you don't need to go there. Like you don't need to go there. Like it's not worth it. You know, I would tell myself that because in one part, I didn't know what it feels like to get there and what it feels like to be there. But I would believe that voice because in the moment of weakness where you're very stressed out, you tend to believe these kinds of things. Now, I would challenge you, if you had this belief, if you had this thought of, you know, I'm already halfway there, you know, this is good enough. I would challenge you to really re-examine that from a perspective of, do you really know if you want something until you're actually there? Until you actually experience it for the first time, especially when you're talking about fitness results. Now, a lot of guys say, you know, I don't need to have a six pack, right? Like, I don't need to get lean enough. And people that have a six pack, they're douchebags. They, you know, they're bad people. You know, they just live in the gym, or they're just, you know, taking drugs. They're just like this weird, they have this weird genetics and all these excuses. And in reality is that the truth is that most of them are really afraid of, you know, the process to get there. And they just simply don't want to pay the price. So they're trying to find excuses for not doing it, for not exiting their comfort zone. Because every time you kind of give yourself this leeway or start becoming looser about something that is outside of your comfort zone, that's worth examining. Because you're not like this when it's inside of your comfort zone. If getting a six pack was just easy like snapping your fingers, of course you would get it. Now, when you're talking about stretching out your comfort zone, now because that's hard, now you're thinking, well, you know, I'm gonna find another excuse for not doing it. And this is really what's been going on with me as well. And every cut, I mean, becomes easier. And every time I get leaner, it becomes easier. But still, those last few percentages are, in one sense, now, even in my situation, are even harder because I'm thinking, I don't have anything to prove to anybody anymore. You know, like, I don't care. You know, I'm just doing it for myself. So it's kind of even easier to find that excuse if I was looking for it. So I'd really urge you guys to kind of re-examine the areas of your life, or especially in fitness, if you're, let's say, in a fat loss phase, definitely re-examine how much self-sabotage is really going on there. How many times do you know give yourself that extra 300-400 calories when you know that that's going to kick you out of a deficit? And if you do that multiple times a week, you've kind of wiped out the weeks of progress there, and you can, you know, go off the rails for a couple of days a week and then completely lose track of what's going on. And really, you feel like you're in a deficit, you feel like you're dieting, you feel like you're stressed out, but because you wiped out results in such a short period of time, you feel like you don't deserve the, you know, like you don't deserve that kind of treatment. You know, the world is not fair because I just ate a little bit more, you know, that kind of feeling. And I've been dieting for 5 days and now I destroyed it in 2 days. And you'd be like, this is not fair. It's not supposed to be like that. You know, these are the types of things that we deal with. This is the internal battle. I remember my first cut that I want to share here with you guys. My internal battle was the fact that I thought that I could never get that lean. You know, I thought that the way my genetics work and the way my body is, that I just can't look like those people. I just can't. It's just not who I am. It's not meant to be. And I didn't even think it was possible. So I had to talk to a lot of people. I try to find a lot of friends and people online that I could interact with. And I was really asking them, did you really do this without any, you know, special drugs or anything like that? And a lot of the guys, I mean, everybody that I met, they were saying, yes, like, it's definitely possible. Like, you don't need to do any, like, crazy shit. Like, you can actually get lean. And this was for me, like, I needed that reinforcement constantly. Otherwise, I found myself falling apart because I couldn't maintain, like my mind wasn't strong enough at that point when it was my first cut. And I didn't have videos like these to tell me where someone would really encourage me and tell me it was possible, you know, that I need to be more patient, that I need to trust the process more, that I need to be more diligent. The closer you get to your goal, the stronger you need to be instead of like getting looser and looser and looser the closer you get to it. I didn't have all of this, so I had to really seek out anybody that I knew in the gym that had a six pack. I would be trying to befriend them and I would try to ask them, you know, what is the magic trick? What is like the special thing? Because again, I thought about stacking all the odds in my favor because I didn't really have the belief in myself that I could do it. And this kind of goes against the common wisdom, right? Like every guy, you know, that gets a six pack, he believes in himself and he's like, you know, visualize it until you get it. No, that's very far from my kind of story because all up until the very end, before I started really seeing the results, I didn't believe it was possible. Like even at the end, I thought like, you know, I'm not sure if this is lean enough. I'm not sure if this is good enough. And these are the kinds of doubts that really, they start eating at you a little bit, right? So they're not that much, you know, at once, but they start influencing those small daily choices that you make. They start making a difference because when you start losing hope, when you start losing the belief that you can actually do it, I'll give you an example. Let's say you go out and you have a little bit more food and you control your calories, but then the next day you wake up and you're like 2-3 pounds heavier. Right? And because you had more sodium in the food, let's say you had Italian food, so it's loaded with sodium, like a pizza or something like that, and you embedded it into your calories, it was all fine. But because you woke up and you're like 3 pounds heavier, now you're thinking, oh my God, like this doesn't work. I mean, I can't, if I'm just gaining 3 pounds and if I just wiped out 3 or 4 weeks of my progress in one night having one pizza, this is not even worth it. And this is the kind of situation where you would lose hope. This is the exact kind of situation where I remember I'd be looking back and like, you know, screw this, like screw this. I'll get a little bit pissed off at, you know, at my body, at the whole process. I'm like, this is not worth it. Like, why am I struggling right now if I, you know, if I can just wipe it out in one night? Because I didn't understand, again, I didn't have the understanding, hey, it's sodium, it's not real fat, it's just water weight fluctuations and you need to average it out and all these good things, but I didn't know. And when you don't know, you start losing hope. And you start losing hope, the next day, I would be a little bit more sloppy. Or the next day, I would show up at the gym, I wouldn't be as motivated. And I would just show up and I was like, yeah, what do I need to work today? What is the workout? You know, like try to find it on my phone. Instead, when I'm very focused, I'm like, okay, I know tomorrow, this is gonna be it. This is the day. This is Bulgarian split squats or whatever it is. Like, I know ahead of time and I'm already mentally preparing myself. I already am so engaged in the process that I'm so focused when I show up in that gym, you know, like time to get the work done. And I find those workouts to be super productive compared to the workouts where I'm mentally weak and my body's the same. My body didn't change overnight. You know, I didn't overnight just get weaker, but mentally I was weak coming into that workout. So instead of me really giving my best and potentially even squeezing out a couple of extra reps or really have the intensity to even progress on a cut, what would happen is I would show up as this weaker version of myself and the workout would be not as productive. And the funny thing that happens, you know, when you have a couple of less productive workouts, when you start hitting plateaus because of your mental weakness, then you start doubting your body as well. Like you start doubting, it's like, yeah, you know, this cut has been too long. You know, I've been drained. I'm dragging this out for too long. I need to, you know, do a break. And then you do a break and then the whole thing falls apart because now you start eating more, but you're not lean enough. And there's so many things that really turn into a self-fulfilling prophecy in this journey. And if you allow yourself that, if you start losing trust in the process, if you allow yourself that little bit of mistrust there, that a little bit of self-judgment or that little bit of thing where you don't believe in yourself, that can actually make a huge impact because everything is a self-fulfilling prophecy. If that pizza that you ate and that sodium, let's say that bumped up your water weight by 2 pounds, now, because you bumped up the water weight by 2 pounds and then you woke up the next day and now you're super stressed out, guess what that extra cortisol is gonna do? That extra cortisol is gonna jack up again your water retention and you're gonna retain even more, even though that day you might be eating only like 1500 calories because you wanted to quote unquote compensate. This often happens, right? You eat 1500 calories and you know, you wake up maybe even the next day heavier and you're like, damn, you know, my metabolism is now broken. You know, I screwed myself over. Like nothing works. this whole thing is just a joke. I need to stop doing this, or I need to switch to the starter diet, or I need to start switching things up. And that's where things start falling apart. So always beware of things that can turn into a self-fulfilling prophecy, and beware of the decisions that you're making. Are they decisions based on a lack of patience? Are you really giving yourself enough time? Are you really understanding the process in and out of what's actually supposed to happen? Do you have any support system, right? Like, one big part why, let's say I use my coaching program as an example, but in general, like having a coach and a mentor, why it helps? Because the coach and the mentor, they're objective, right? Like, if you go to a surgeon and if you ask, hey, like, would you operate on yourself or on a family member, they couldn't do it because they're very subjective. They're emotionally attached to themselves and to the people around them. So they can help someone else and they can be completely objective and they can do that. But having someone as like a person who's looking at you from the outside, it can really help to realign you in those moments that you need that help, when you're really faced with these internal challenges, when someone can tell you, look, it's okay, right? It happened to me as well. And that's one of the reasons why I'm making this video. It's okay, it happened to me as well. Like, trust the process, give it a little bit more time. Don't freak out. You know, just to tell you to calm down a little bit. And just by doing that, sometimes can make a difference between you having visible, steady progress on the scale and not having that steady progress. Because in the fat loss phase, especially as you get down to 10% and below, the stress that you're dealing with, everything is a little bit amplified, right? Everything is a little bit more amplified. So things that might happen at work, now that's stressed out, you get stressed out, you're gonna get more stressed out because of other stressors. And all the stressors are kind of compounding and they're taken away from your recovery ability as a whole. So it can be really tough. And this is where you have to be mentally re-engaging with certain philosophies. I personally like the Stoic philosophy, where I'm disengaging with things that I can't control and I'm focusing only on things that I can control. This is my favorite philosophy, and generally I subscribe to this way of thinking. Like, I'm not gonna worry about something I can't control. Like, I'm not gonna worry about things that are, even if they're influencing me, but I can't do anything about it, I'm not gonna worry about it. I'm gonna really work on not worrying about it. Because I'm a worrier. I would worry about everything if I had a choice. So I had to work on this philosophy a lot in my life to be able to detach myself a little bit. And in my mastermind, we have a saying, you know, data over emotion. Always data over emotion. This is one of our core values, is that we always look at the data. We try not to make decisions based on emotions. If you're making your decisions based on the way you feel or your emotions, you're gonna be having a very hard time succeeding, not just in fitness, but in any area of your life. Because those decisions are just based on a temporary emotional state that can change throughout the day even. And the decisions, they're completely illusional, because your brain is irrational. Like, your brain can't really deal with all these situations. So those decisions are often very bad decisions. Like, hey, I don't feel like going to the gym today, so you don't go to the gym. In reality, like, if you make a decision based on what the best version of yourself would do, or based on an identity, or based on simply like what's the goal and what's the habit and what does the data say, you are much better off, because the data is objective and the numbers don't lie. And this is a really hard shift to make, like, very, very hard shift. And even when you make the shift, like I've made the shift years ago, you still have those emotions there. You still have to deal with them. So I guess, you know, this is a little bit of a long-winded video, but I really want to give you guys some perspective, is that you're not alone in this journey if you have those internal battles. Remember, this is the half. Half of the journey is the internal battle, half of it is external. Half of it is mindset, the other half is tactics, strategies, and action and execution, right? This is the same for every journey in your life. This is the same if you wanna build a big company, same if you wanna build, you know, like, awesome relationships with people. It's the same thing. There's always gonna be internal challenges, there's always gonna be external challenges. For me, my internal challenges were much, much stronger and harder to overcome than my external challenges. Because I'm a nerdy guy, you know. If I need to research stuff, I'm gonna research stuff. I'm gonna read, you know, dozens of books. And I read like 500 books on topics of fitness, personal development, business, and everything. And I feel like knowledge was never really the obstacle for me. Because I love knowledge. I have the knowledge bug. I will read until, like, I won't even sleep. I will learn, watch videos, do all kinds of things. And I will seek help, I will reach out, I will find the right process, I will find coaches, mentors, books, and everything to help me optimize things. But then my biggest challenge is always the mindset side of things, and that's what I had to work on a lot to really become knowledgeable and to know ins and outs of how the human mind works as much as I can, to be able to help people, and first to be able to help myself so I can then help other people really stay on track and be consistent with their fitness goals. This internal battle is the missing piece that I see a lot of people out there in the fitness world totally ignoring. You know, they're giving you tips for how to be less hungry, but maybe that hunger that you're experiencing might not even be real hunger. It might be just stress-induced cravings. And if you're not addressing the root cause of that stress, which could be like you're breaking up with your girlfriend or something, you know, how are you supposed to deal with, you know, you're basically treating the symptoms instead of addressing the cause. And this is what I'm really big on. I'm big on this holistic approach and looking at life as a whole and seeing what is really causing those problems that you have. And this is, again, something I'm pointing your guys' attention to, is that you as a human being, you're not like in the gym and everything else you're just isolating yourself from. There's always an interaction between all areas of your life with whatever you're doing in the gym and whatever you're doing with your nutrition, whatever you're doing with anything in your life, there's an interaction. So look at yourself as a whole and always look at, you know, those things in your life that you can actually control and make better, because if you make your relationship better with your girlfriend or your boyfriend or whoever you're in a relationship with, or even family or whoever, that actually will make your diet easier. That will make your workout better. It's funny how this works, but improving, you know, getting a promotion at your job, you will actually diet better. Like, you will be more adherent because you're gonna be a happier person. You're gonna do a better workout because you're gonna be less stressed out. So keep in mind, like, there's a lot of things in, that's why I'm such a big fan of personal development, because fitness is a part of personal development, because I'm seeing how these things interact. So you have to realize that a lot of internal battles aren't just coming from fitness. They're also coming from other areas of your life. So be always, as a type of person that I would like you to be, is the type of person who is looking for the edge in any area of your life, looking for the next thing, the next goal, and really being there, being present, and improving yourself as a person, instead of just looking at, you know, how am I gonna get as jacked as possible so I can be better than other people, or, you know, feed my ego so I can be more confident, I can do this and this. You know, all those things, you know, you will be more confident if you get, you know, your fitness goal, if you really work on this area of your life. But focus more on like comparing yourself and seeing what area of your life you can improve. Like, which one of those has, let's say, been at 5 out of 10 instead of closer to 10 out of 10. So if your fitness is like 9 out of 10 or 8 out of 10, and you're, let's say, never going out, you have no social life whatsoever, and if that's like 2 out of 10, that's the area of your life that if you work on that area of life a little bit, even your fitness results will improve, because you will be a happier person in general. Like, you will be just a more rounded person, and you will become, you know, the person in your prime, the person who is really on point with all areas of your life. And that's what I want you, that's what I want for you. Like, I want you to be that complete person. So when I meet you in real life, and I meet a lot of you guys from the channel, you know, I'm meeting some great people, and I know you guys are doing this already, and you are working on all areas of your life. So when I meet you, like, we're not just talking about getting jacked, but we're talking about, you know, traveling the world, you know, crushing career, business, relationships, everything, and fitness. I want you to be that, you know, superhero, right? That's the thing, but a real superhero, not just like, you know, in terms of the physique, but as a whole, like in your entire life. I want you to be the person that other people can rely on, the leader of that. We need those types of people in the world to make the world a better place. And that's what I want to leave you guys with. This is my message in this video. Focus on internal battles. Don't neglect your mindset work. Of course, focus on the tactics and the knowledge and on the external stuff, but also don't neglect the mindset. Don't neglect what's really happening, and work on both. And you guys will see amazing success. I would love to hear from you in the comments, actually, how you guys feel about this idea. If you enjoyed it, if you feel like this is something that you can relate to, let me know in the comments below. Make sure to hit the like as well in the video. It really helps a lot. And when I see that you guys enjoy these types of videos, it really inspires me to put more content out on YouTube. And I'm very focused on my business, and I'm focused on my clients. So I try to do my best to really put out some cool stuff on YouTube for you guys that you can relate to. So I hope you're enjoying this. And I will see you guys in the next video. All right, peace.